Alone in the wilderness. Well, here I am, attempting to survive 48 hours in this vast, pristine, wild country. Who knows what nature will bring upon me? I hope I can survive this solitude. This will make a mighty fine stir for my stew. Well, it's 5 o'clock, my first day alone in the wilderness. It can get lonely out here, too lonely. But my neighbor, Ole, from the next mountain over, stopped by to visit, invited me to a party. But he warned me, though, it's going to be a lot of fighting. And I said, well, I can handle myself. He said, yeah, there's going to be a lot of drinking, too. And I said, well, I could use a beer about now. He said, there's also going to be some wild, wild sex. I said, well, I don't know about that, but I'm not embarrassed by anything. And I asked him, well, what should I wear? He said, it don't matter, it's just me and you. Well, I think I'm going to stay home tonight. Yeah, I had just brought down some firewood. You know, it came down during the winter. Now I'm going to stack it up and let it dry, and I'll saw it later when it's a lot harder, and I'll dull my chain some more.
I almost rolled it in some deer droppings.
Some people take satisfaction in doing things the old-fashioned way with hand tools and all of that stuff. I think that's just plain stupid. Well, that's it. The last nail, my cabin is done. It took me almost 3 hours to do it, but it was well worth it. A lot of hard work. Well, I think it's time to go in and put a movie in the VCR and then call it a day. Well, but on second thought, I think I'll pop a beer and play with some more sharp power tools and firearms and then sit back and relax another cold Canadian lager. That sounds like a good plan. Well, it's April 17th. This is the second day of my alone in the wilderness survival test. Not here, you need survival techniques to be able to live off the land. I got hungry for a trout. It's nice and peaceful out here. As long as the geese don't make up a racket. Or a beaver slaps the water when I spook it. You have to have patience when you're fishing for trout. Now, come to think of it, I wanted fish, but I don't think it was trout. Got all hungry for tuna, bumblebee. Well, I'll give it one more time. You have to have patience, but also you got a whole bunch of work to do out here, and you can't be wasting it on waiting for your bobber to get a hit. Well, I guess the fish aren't biting today. Just as well. I just caught a glimpse of my other neighbor, Scotty McPherson. So I'll head on up and see what he wants. That's the loon.
Hello all ye Flatlanders, Scotty McPherson here. I just wanted to say, with a hat like this, you cannot miss. I'm just gonna go on and enjoy me breakfast. You all have a good day now.
Well, it's a beautiful day in the West Canada Creek. Time to test the, it's getting kind of windy, so we're going to test the, how the microphone picks up the wind and the conversation and all that while I'm sharpening the chain on the chainsaw. Got pretty dull with the wood I cut so far in the past couple of days.